हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करसगे ऑर्किड स्कूल। माई सेल्फ स्नेहल माने, टीचिंग यू साइंस फॉर ग्रेड 6। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टार्टेड न्यू लेसन, लेसन नंबर 7, गेटिंग टू नो प्लांट्स। सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ प्लांट्स। व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ प्लांट्स दैट वी हैव स्टडीड? हर्ब्स, श्रब्स एंड ट्रीज। सो दीज आर ग्रुप्ड इन टू कैटेगरीज according to their size, stems, yes. So besides this, one more plant we have studied. What is that? Can anyone remember? Yes, very good. It's creeper and climbers. Okay, creepers and climbers both have weak stem. Creepers creep along the ground and climbers grow with a support. We have also studied the different parts of a plant. We have studied in detail about leaves. Okay. Now in this class, we will study more about roots and other plant parts such as flowers and fruits. Okay. So let us see. Roots. The part of a plant that grows under the ground is called root system. The part of the plant that grows under the ground is called root system. As you know, this is an underground part of the plant. This binds the soil. And allows a plant to stand straight. It always grows towards the gravity and moisture and away from the light. It is always grown in the moisture and away from the light. The root and its branches make up the root system of a plant. Root is the underground part of a plant body. It is non-green. Root grows in the soil and away from the light. So mainly there are two types of roots. One is tap root and the other is fibrous root. As you can see, two types of root mainly. So let us see about these types of roots in detail. See, this is the example of tap root. The main root is known as tap root, which while small branches arising from it are called as lateral roots. So this is the main root and these are the small roots which are called as lateral roots arising from the main root. These are the lateral roots which are arising from the main root. In some plants, a single root is called primary root. This may also called as primary root. Comes out from the seed after germination. This is the root which comes out after the germination. It is thicker as its upper part and generally tapers downwards. It is thick, means it is little bit big in size and thick, and it grows downwards. The primary roots gives out several branches in every direction. This is the main root which gives lateral roots in any direction and the several roots can be formed in any other direction. These smaller branches are called as lateral roots, or those are also called as secondary roots. See, the first name, that this is the main root and these are the lateral roots. The other name for this is called as this is the primary root and this is the secondary root. This type of root is called tap root. Mango, neem, pine, carrot and radish are examples of plants in which tap root is found. These are the examples of the plants in which we find the tap root. Next, about fibrous root. fibrous root comes out in the place of a tap root. The tap root is short-lived and it is replaced by a cluster of thin fiber like fibrous root. Some common plants which bear fibrous roots are the crop plants like wheat, maize, paddy, rice and grasses. In some plant, a bunch of thin fiber like roots arise from the base of the stem. These are called as fibrous roots. The cluster of equal sized roots arising from the base of the plant. See, in the previous tap root, what do we have? A main root and then lateral roots. But this does not have any main root or lateral root. Just it is a cluster of many roots arising from the base of the plant. These type of roots are known as fibrous roots. Grass, maize, wheat, onion and rice are example of plants in which fibrous roots are found. Next, venation and root system. You can see, as we have seen before about the leaves, so one leaf is having reticulate venation where the veins are in the form of a network, and other is about the parallel venation where the veins are arranged parallel to each other, So the venation where we have the reticulate venation, the root system is tap root system, and where we have the parallel venation, the root system is this type of means fibrous root system. Venation and root system. So tap root we have reticulate venation and fibrous root we have parallel venation. So let us see a video.
Root is an underground cylindrical part of the plant which grows vertically down in the soil opposite to sunlight. The first embryonic root that comes out from a plant seed is called the radicle. This forms the primary true root of a young plant. Some roots called adventitious roots originate from stem or leaf tissue rather than from base of the stem. Roots show much variability in their shape and structure, which is related either to their function or environmental condition. Roots are non-green in color, as they lack chlorophyll and never bear leaves, flowers, fruits, or buds or nodes like stem. Root of some plants have one main thick primary root and many smaller roots called lateral or secondary roots. Such roots are found in dicot plants such as gram, pea, etc. and are called tap root, whereas some plant roots as in monocot plants, maize, has no main thick root and instead have a cluster of roots of the same thickness and size arising from base of the stem. These are called fibrous roots. The end part of the root branches bear fine hair-like processes called root hairs. The primary root with all its branches and root hairs constitute root system. Root hairs penetrate deep in the soil by pushing or displacing the soil pieces in their way. Roots are usually sub-cylindrical in shape and tapering towards the tip. In comparison to stem, roots are much more bent because their growth in soil is affected by many obstructions. Root hairs efficiently absorb water and dissolved minerals from the soil. As they greatly increase the absorbing surface of the root and achieve much greater contact with soil particles. Such delicate structure survives for a few days only and grows out into the soil for a few millimeters. Each root hair is made of a single cell. The roots help in anchoring the plant firmly in the soil. The depth of root depends upon the spatial and temporal availability of water and nutrients and the physical properties of the soil. Apart from absorbing water and anchoring the plant firmly in the soil, some roots perform special functions such as roots of leguminous plant contain symbiotic bacteria that fix atmospheric nitrogen. Hanging roots of orchids draw moisture from the air. Roots of plants found in marshy or waterlogged area absorb atmospheric air for respiration. Such plants have breathing roots or pneumatophores above the ground. In certain plants like radish and carrot, the primary roots usually get thickened to store food. Roots bind the soil together so that it does not get washed away during rain or blown away by the wind, and thus protect the environment by preventing soil erosion.
So this was about the root system. Now we will see about flower. You all know flower is the colorful part of the root of the shoot system. Flower is formed on the branches, so it comes under the shoot system. So it is the colorful part of the flower. It is the colorful part of the shoot system. It is also called as reproductive organ of the plant. It is also called as reproductive organ of the plant. Part of a flower, sepals. Parts of a flower are sepals, petals, stamen, male reproductive organ, pistil, female reproductive organ. So these are the parts of a flower. We are going to see about this in detail. This is the structure of the flower. This is the structure of the flower. So you can see this is called as flower stalk, which is also called as pedicel. This is called as thalamus. This is the filament. This is the anther. This is the petal. This is the stigma. This is the style. This is ovule, ovary and sepal. And anther and filament together are called as stamen. Let us go through this all the parts once again. This is the flower stalk, which is pedicel. The part which is attached to this ovary is called thalamus. These are called as filament. These are anthers. These are petals. This is stigma. This is style. This is ovule. This is ovary. This is sepal. So these are the parts of a flower. So before going to this, we'll see a video.
Flowers are one of the most beautiful creations on Mother Earth. According to the biologists, morphologically, the flower is a compressed shoot and reproductive organ in angiosperms, the flowering plants. Although flowers have astonishingly varied sizes, shapes, odor, and colors, they still possess the same basic structure. A typical flower has a pedicel, which is the stalk that holds the flower, and the thalamus, which is enlarged part of the stalk that bears all the parts of flower. On the basis of presence or absence of pedicel, flowers are classified into pedicellate and sessile respectively. Rose is a pedicellate flower, while bottle brush is a sessile flower. A typical flower has four whorls. Outer two whorls consist of accessory organs and inner two whorls consist of essential organs. The accessory organs consist of sepals and petals, also known as calyx and corolla respectively. Calyx is usually green in color, and during the bud stage, it protects the inner organs of the young flower. Some flowers like Dhatura have fused or united sepals, while others like Rose has free sepals. Corolla is generally large, elaborate, bright colored and sweet smelling, which helps in attracting insects, moths and honeybees during pollination. Like sepals, petals are also united as well as free. For example, blue bell flower has fused petals, while aster flower has free petals. In monocotyledon plants, the calyx and the corolla are undifferentiated and they are collectively called as perianth, while the individual members are known as tepals. The essential organs are stamens or microsporophylls, which form the androecium, that is the male reproductive organ of the flower, and the carpels or megasporophylls, which form the gynoecium, that is female reproductive organ of the flower. The stamen is a cylindrical stalk-like structure which consists of proximal sterile part called the filament and a distal fertile part, an anther. The anther consists of four microsporangia, also known as pollen sacs. These pollen sacs are separated by a thin layer of tissue known as connective. Each pollen sac contains numerous pollen grains or microspores. When mature anther dehisces, pollen grains are released from it. The carpel is divided into a proximal ovule-bearing part known as the ovary, a distal pollen receptive part known as the stigma, and a median sterile part called the style. The style holds the stigma, and carpel is also known as the pistil. The ovary has one or more chambers known as locules. The ovules are attached to the walls of the ovary with the help of a structure called the placenta. The pattern of ovule arrangement in the ovary is called placentation. Different flowers bloom at different times of the year. Some plants like Vinca rosea bloom throughout the year, while blooming in some parts like neem and mango occurs once in a year. Flowers are always the best way to express our feelings, no matter what the reason or occasion might be. They are the ultimate ornaments to enhance aesthetics of a place.
So this video was about the flower. Which kind of venation can be seen in the leaves of the plants having fibrous root system? Can you tell me, in fibrous root system, which type of venation do we have? is it reticulate venation, parallel venation or lateral roots? The answer is parallel venation. That is, the leaf venation and the type of root system, the leaf venation and the type of root system are related to each other. Plants having leaves with parallel venation, plants having leaves with parallel venation have fibrous roots, have fibrous root system. Example, grass, banana, wheat. On the other hand, plants with reticulate venation leaves show taproot system. So, as we have seen about all the plant parts, just we will have a quick review over it. So, we have seen about the parts of plants, those are leaves, flowers, yes. So, let us see one by one in detail. So, parts of plants, this is the flower, leaf, stem and then roots. There are two types of root system. One is taproot system and other is fibrous root system. This is the stem, this is leaf. Leaf has two types of venation, as the leaves have veins on them. Veins are of two types, one is of parallel venation and the other is of reticulate venation. In reticulate venation, the veins are arranged in the form of a network, and in parallel venation, the veins are in the form of the lines which are parallel to each other. So, that is why we gave the name as parallel venation. See, reticulate venation and parallel venation. Reticulate venation have the roots of lateral roots and taproot system is for reticulate venation, and parallel venation leaves are for fibrous root system. Flower. Flowers are most beautiful part of a plant. Different plants have different types of flowers. Flowers are of many sizes, shapes and colors. They have different kinds of fragrances. Some common flowers are hibiscus, rose, jasmine, sunflower, marigold and lily. And flowers contain reproductive organ of the plant. The flower is attached to the stem by a stalk. It is attached by a stalk called pedicel. The upper part of the stalk is somewhat swollen. The swollen part of the pedicel is known as thalamus. Other parts of the flower are arranged in rings or whorls on the thalamus. Some flowers do not have a pedicel and called sessile flowers. So, this is the petals, this is the stamen, this is pistil, this is style, this is ovule, this is ovaries and this is sepal. So, the main parts of the flower are sepals, petals, stamen and pistil. Sepals are green leaf like parts in the outermost circle of a flower are called sepals. Petals, these are usually bright colored due to presence of colored pigment. The bright colored petals serve to attract insects that help in pollination. Stamen, they are found just inside the petals. They are usually 4 to 6 in number. The stamen in the male reproductive part of a flower. Each stamen consists of a thin stalk called as filament and a two lobed headed structure called as anther. This is called as anther. Each anther lobe has two pollen sacs. One anther lobe has two different pollen sacs. They are filled with the pollen grains. Pollen grains are yellow fine dust like particles that contain the male organs. Next, pistil. Pistil is in the center of the flower. There is a flask shaped organ called pistil. The pistil is female reproductive part of the flower. Each pistil consists of stigma and style and ovary. The top part of the pistil is called stigma. The swollen part of the base at ovary, this is ovary. A tube like structure is called as style. style connects stigma to the ovary. Stigma receives pollen grains from the anthers, and these pollen grains are carried to the ovary through style. So this is about the parts of a flower. Parts of a flower. So we will have a review by a video.
Learning objectives. Students will learn about parts of plants, location and function of each part in brief. On planet Earth, plants are the only living organism that can make their food by themselves. Rest of the organisms depend on plant products for their survival. Plants have five basic parts: roots, stem, leaves, flowers, and fruits. Root is an underground and non-green part of the plant, which grows deep into the soil and helps in anchoring the plant into the soil. Root is covered with root hair, which helps in absorbing water and minerals from the soil required for the plant's growth. Stem is the main axis of the plant and grows above the ground to support the aerial parts of the plant. Young stem is green, and on maturity it turns brown. It is divided into nodes and internodes. Nodes are the points from where branching takes place. The stem helps in carrying water from roots to leaves and food from leaves to other parts of the plant. Leaves are the green part of the plant. They are green due to the presence of chlorophyll in them. Chlorophyll helps the leaves to absorb sunlight and prepare food by the process of photosynthesis. A simple leaf consists of petiole and lamina. Petiole is the small stalk by which leaves are attached to the stem or branch. Lamina is the flat, thin and broad part with conspicuous system of vein and veinlets. Flower is the reproductive colorful structure of plants. Each flower has 3 to 4 whorls. Flowers have the same basic whorls like stamen and carpel. Stamen and carpel are specialized male and female parts that facilitate sexual reproduction in plants. Color, fragrances, and nectars of flowers are important for pollination, and pollination is obligatory for fruit formation. Fruits are the important parts of flowering plant. They develop from the ripened ovary of the flower. Generally, they are sweet and fleshy and an important food item. Fruits bear seeds. Their main function is to protect the seeds from unfavorable conditions. Fruit, flower, leaf, and stem are generally located above the ground. Thus, they belong to the shoot system. However, roots are normally located under the ground and belong to the root system of a plant.
So, in this video, we have seen about all the basic structures of a plant, and we have studied about all the different parts of a plant in detail, and its uses, types of plants, types of roots, types of venation, and much more. So, you can read the lesson, and if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Thank you, students.